Hi, why did I start showing my face on the camera? Well, very simple. I realized that the YouTube and social media game is personality driven. I started my YouTube in school. I was at uni at that time, in 2017, if I clearly remember. And I didn't want people to know what I do in the internet. I do that like almost every day, even when I used to make beats. I didn't want people to know what I was doing on the internet. So I decided to start making videos that I don't show my face. You know, those voiceover videos. But the thing is, I'm now graduate from university and I quickly realized that I don't really care much about those people. Their opinion don't really matter to me.
Their opinion don't really matter to me.
Their opinion don't really matter to me.
I don't mean that in a wrong way. Some of the people I met in university, I care about them and I love them dearly. But on my daily life right now, how much did they really impact it? How much their opinion really impact my life right now?
It doesn't.
And that's like that most part of life. And I came to the realization also that no matter how many people you have around you, you are alone in the end of the day. So you have to make the best with what you have. And that's one of the reasons also why I stopped being shy. Let's get back to the YouTube game. The YouTube is personality driven. People build connection with the people that they see. Just look at the top YouTube or social media influencer. They show their face. They don't hide behind camera. They show. Even if you are ugly, it seems like there's a correlation between being ugly and successful on the social media, except if you are a woman. But there's Lily Singh. She's not that bad looking. But your look doesn't really matter. Look at Casey Neistat, KSI, Mr. Beast. Those are not good looking people. So look doesn't really matter on the internet. It's your personality. It's your personality that build your channel, the connection that you build with your audience. And it will be extremely difficult for you to build a connection with your audience if they don't see you. They don't know who you are. Even those channels that do voiceovers, the people build a connection with their voice. Once they change the voiceover, the people tend to leave their channel because it's not the same people. And those are details that I noticed. If I wanna be big here, if I wanna make the best here, I have to show my face. I have nothing to hide. And that's the reason why I start showing your face and why you should show your face on the internet. If your intention is to build a connection with your audience, they must know who you are. At least how you look, they must know that. And one more thing for those that most people don't know about doing voiceover video. Those voiceover videos require more work than those type of video. Actually, one of my video that I did like this only took me less than an hour to get it done. But the voiceover video, it will take like 10 hours, 20 hours straight just to get it done. So that time will be better spent if I improve the way I present myself in the camera instead of trying to be on the computer all day long doing the editing. No, if I present myself on camera, will be much better. So from now on, my channel will be like that. I will show my face and I will interpret the fact like this. I will not hide behind camera anymore. So get used to me. And I hope you like my shadow. I'm changing the direction, but the way the style is not changing that much. It's improving actually. I will maintain the quality, but you will see my face. I will talk to you eyes to eyes. So hi, I will show my face on camera, even if I have to learn how to have presence on the camera, because those are a valuable skill, how to have presence on the camera. And how to speak in public. Not really in public, it's in front of the camera, but still, it's a valuable skill. And that's how we build my channel. And also, you improve the way I speak. I think I'm speaking a bit slowly here. I don't speak that slow, I speak really fast. But the problem is, when I start speaking really fast, my Portuguese accent start to come. It'll be like, hello, how are you doing? You guys. Anyway, that's all for today. Thanks for staying.